Hey. Songs that are on my CD, and I got here so late this weekend that I didn't get a chance to get my CD in the store before it was time to take them out of the store again. So I'll have them for sale out in the lobby at the end of the show. Just that's just a plug so I can get my airfare home. And here's another tune I'd like to do for you. This is an old Delta blues sort of thing. It's called Rollin' and Tumblin'. Waking up there? Woo! Okay, Madcat, tell me, how about you?
Thank you. And that was Peter Madcat Ruth playing, I think, in 1997 at a spa. Many of you may know that Madcat was one of the main reasons that I ended up being involved in spa on the board level. He came down to the Kerrville Folk Festival and amongst others, Joe Felisco and Winslow Yerksa, and asked me to come up here and start working with SPA. So I have a very fond place in my heart for our friend Peter Madcat Ruth and his wonderful performances. Welcome to our last evening. This is, you know, day four, as we all know, and we would normally be sitting here in our tuxedos. I'm sitting here in one of my favorite performance shirts, and I would be sitting out looking at this wonderful view of 500 people eating while I'm standing on the stage, and I usually would invite Carl up or Ernie or somebody to come up and take a picture so that you could all see what I can see, because it's such a beautiful sight. And so I can only imagine it sitting here at this point and just think about what it was like last year and what it'll be like next year in my mind's eye. I want to thank all of you who've done so much to help us put this on. The generosity, the support in the Zoom rooms, on YouTube, the chatting, the questions, of course, all the performers, all of the seminar presenters, and all the organization that went on to pull this together. We've had well over 1,500 views of each of our performances over the course of the last few days, and of our sessions, those YouTube videos that are posted out there. All eight of those videos will stay there as long as possible. The shows will stay there, as I hope, in perpetuity. The seminars, as long as we can. We've had a special request to leave up the Jim session yesterday and Kelly's session yesterday on working on your harmonica, the tin sandwich, and they've given us permission to load that one on separately, so that one will be up there in perpetuity as well for those of you who want to tackle that. We've had more than 200 people most days in the Zoom and YouTube rooms. That's fabulous, and we really appreciate it. We've had people from all over the world joining us for these sessions, and I'm hopeful that there will be, you know, as many of them here with us tonight as we go into our awards show. I would, for the last time, like to thank our sponsors. Without them, we may not have started down this path to pull on SPA Week 2020. And so let me thank Honer, Eastop, Seidel, Blows Me Away, Lone Wolf, Kong Sheng, and Golden Bird. Without you, literally, this may not have happened. And certainly, then the rest of you who've donated and continue this evening, I've been watching the generosity this evening as we get emails from the donations, are fabulous. And our, on behalf of our performers and presenters, I thank you deeply for everything that you've done for them. We've got a couple of intermissions later on tonight, so stick around for those between the awards and the various acts. And we've got three fabulous performances this evening. Those of you who watched Antonio Serrano's masterclass a little while ago on Zoom will be looking forward to hearing him play sitting at his piano at his home now Eastern Spain. He used to be in Madrid and he's now in Eastern Spain. We will follow that with The Message, which is Tom Stryker's big band. And they did a special performance for us, appropriately socially distant. And you might see some cool stuff in there at the beginning. So make sure you're here to watch that, the start of that show. And then we will end up with Hermine Deurloo. And she was last year's Harmonica Player of the Year. And so we're very pleased to have her with us this evening. She might, in fact, be on the Zoom with us. And I hope I pronounced her name properly. I have. Given my last name and the number of ways it can be pronounced, I try to be very, very careful with that. We're, I think, probably going to open the chat up again this evening for those of you who want to stick around after the last show. Last night, I gather it went on till 3 in the morning. So for many people, it really was very much like SPA. I certainly got up this morning and felt like I had been at SPAH for 4 days. Maybe not the physical exertion, because I wasn't running around the hotel as much as usual, but certainly I'm certainly looking forward to having a good night's sleep and doing a lot less tomorrow than I've done the last week or two. And but it has been a labor of love for all of us. We've really enjoyed doing this. Jerry's going to be joining me here in a little while as we go through the awards presentation. We talked earlier on with about 55 people, I'm very pleased to say, at our annual general meeting, and spent an hour talking about the business of SPAH. And we both made the point that it's hard work, but we do it because we love it. We do it because we really enjoy watching the faces of the people, the feedback, the music that we get to hear from all of these wonderful performers. And most of these performances that you've seen over the last 4 days probably wouldn't have happened if we hadn't put this together. And so we've created some artifacts for the future that are unique and probably will never happen. Looking at Rob Preparozzi's last night, and so forth. So I think we've got some amazing recordings that will live on now. You've seen a lot of the recordings we've played from the 90s. These are obviously higher quality, and I've been very impressed with the quality we've been able to put out over YouTube. So I hope if you haven't watched any of those shows that you will do so in the future. We're going to leave them up there for as long as we can, and hopefully again the evening shows we'll leave them up there in perpetuity. We've had a lot of conversation with people about how we take this forward, this idea of a virtual convention. And there are a lot of good ideas that we've heard about doing some sort of a teach-in, about maybe going, you know, when we can, going to another venue where there are performers and recording that and then bringing that in here. As a 100% volunteer organization, we have to be careful about how we use our resources. We are very busy in February through August in putting on what we hope will be the 2021 live convention in Charlotte, North Carolina, the second week of August. But we would love to find a way to use this idea, this approach, to bring more music to more people, more harmonica expression to more people. The fact that we've had people from Argentina, from Brazil, from Australia, from China, from all over Europe is something we would never have achieved in a live setting sitting in St. Louis. And so that is a wonderful feeling. And it also allows us to bring more international performers who might otherwise be touring and unable to join us, or not be able to come in for one reason or another because of visas or cost and time and all those things. So it has been a wonderful expression and an opportunity for us to try something very new, and we've learned a lot from doing it. So I really hope that we can find interesting ways to use what we've learned from this and apply that to the future of SPAH. And I welcome your comments. I said this during the meeting, if anybody has other ideas about this. Todd Parrott gave us a wonderful one earlier. Please send an email to info@spah.org. Jerry and I and a few others get those emails, and we'll include that in our thinking. Give us an idea about what you think we might do and whether you can help us, because in many respects, it is resources that constrain us because we are a volunteer organization and we're all pretty busy except for the times that we're spending with our families and friends. And so we could use some help if we're going to do more of that. That's one of the things I loved about Todd's idea, is that it uses the teach-in idea as a way to bring more content. So we'll look for more of those things. As I usually do on the last evening, I want to thank the team of people that have helped us pull this together. About this time, I would usually ask you to stand up and cheer for all the hotel staff. This time, I'm going to ask you to stand up and give a big round of applause to Chris, who's in my ear, talking to me here. and also to Dave, who's been running the Zoom room. Together, these guys have worked incredibly hard over the last month, and particularly over the last 2 weeks, to rehearse everybody, to give us the technology, to manage this process, to allow us to do the things that we've done, broadcasting what we're doing right now into Zoom, into YouTube, with a kind of quality and precision, from the lighting and the settings to where I'm sitting and the amount of room above my head. And it's wonderful to work with professionals. I'm very pleased that Dave will be joining us next year. And who knows, maybe we'll find a role for Chris too. It's certainly been a pleasure, Chris. I know you can hear me. On the SPA side, Paul Davies, who was one of our MCs here and has been a backup MC for many of the evenings. David Burnson, who has a new job as Mr. Radio Voice, and also what a wonderful MC he was last night. We had a wonderful time watching him last night. Mike Weiscarver and Franklin Cobos, who helped us pull together all the seminars, and Keith Mitchell, who joined them to help us operate and run those seminar series throughout the day. That whole process, you know, doing one seminar series was sort of my expression of, let's try something we know we can accomplish. We had people ask us, can we do breakouts? Could we have other rooms and so forth? We wanted to do something we knew we could do very well and bring you a high quality product and high quality content. With people, it takes a lot of people to make sure all the pieces work together. Sometimes things break. And so I really appreciate all the work they've done. Doug, for the wonderful graphics that we have. By the way, we've had a request for t-shirts. We're going to look into whether we can get a good quality shirt. If we can, we will email everybody we can find who has donated or been a part of this or is a member and ask you if you would like to buy one. Obviously, the fulfillment will be through one of the internet houses, but we've asked Doug to go and look into that. Please also remember, if you've got a cool photograph of yourself, please use that email address that's posted on Facebook and send those photos into Doug. And then the supporting cast, you know, Jay, Lucy, Phil Duncan, Phil Franklin, all the rest. And most importantly, for the next 30 to 45 minutes, Winslow Yerxa, who chairs our awards committee. He, I know, is in the Zoom room now. He's instrumental in helping us manage the awards process and pulling together all the information about all the nominees that you send us. Those are only nominated by members. And so I really want to thank him for that diligence and that wonderful work and all the context that he brings and knowledge that he brings to the committee that meets. We actually only met about 8 days ago to come up with the award nominees, or to take the award nominees and come up with the winners. And that was quite hard. And so, and then last, but by certainly not least, I would like to welcome to the stage my very good friend and vice president, Mr. Jerry Deal. And with a bit of luck, Jerry's going to show up right over here. There he is. Hi, Jerry.
So, hello, everybody.
We're going to start our awards ceremony here. We're hoping, oh, look, we got the titles. Hey, look, got my name up there. How about that? We're hoping to have each of our award winners this evening with us on the telephone. Obviously, we can't have them here with us in person. But the telephone felt like the easiest way to bring them into this experience. So Jerry and I are going to work together, and you'll see one of us duck out for a while to get somebody on the phone and so forth. And we'll work through the process, and so stick with us, and we'll have some fun with this. Each year, we give 3 awards to honor outstanding members of the harmonica community. This year is no different. We now have 25 nominees for these awards, all submitted by SPA members in good standing. And so I'm now going to explain a little bit about the first award, which is the Stan Harper Award of Special Merit. And while I do that, I'm going to say goodbye to Jerry for just a little while, so Jerry can go get our first award winner on the telephone while I tell you who the nominees were. So Jerry, take it away, and I'm going to go down the list here. So the Stan Harper Award of Special Merit is the candidate must have benefited the harmonica community and be deserving of a singular honor. They may be individuals who do not play the harmonica. They may be organizations. The nominees for the Stan Harper Award in 2020 are a 97-year-old World War II veteran, ballgame celebrity, harmonica promoter, harmonica Pete Dupre. The second nominee is player and SPAH Youth Committee Chair, Cynthia Dussel Bacon. Third is player and custom harmonica builder and teacher, Joe Felisco, who many of you know. And I'd like to welcome my lovely wife, Brenda Freed, to the stage. So I asked Brenda to come up here. Brenda has been making sure that I have been well fed and looked after while I've been up in this room for the last 4 days, and has been joining in the festivities downstage. Thank you very much for doing that.
You're welcome.
Chris, by the way, I could hear Jerry while that was going on. Our fourth nominee, long-term SPAH membership director, Phil Franklin, who has been membership director for 8 years. Player, teacher, and author, Adam Gussow. Player, teacher, and harmonica repair technician, George Miklas, who has been with us here all week. Player, researcher, and author, Pat Misson. Chicago Tribune music critic, Howard Reich. And player, teacher, and former Twin Cities Harmonica Club president, Steve Watney, who has also been with us here. I hope that Jerry is able to join us again.
We're good.
So this year we have two award recipients. And the first winner, please join me in welcoming George Miklas.
Okay, so George can only hear me. I've got him on my speaker. Can you hear him? We're good. Okay, go ahead, George.
Thank you, Michael, Jerry, Winslow, nomination committee, and the board of directors for selecting me as the 2020 recipient of the Stan Harper Award of Special Merit. I love SPAH, and I love what it represents, harmonica players. We are a society, a community with a common bond, friends, colleagues, and family. I love that we preserve the past by celebrating all varieties of harmonica players and styles, blues, country, jazz, classical, and ensemble. I love that we actively advance the harmonica by supporting initiatives to encourage youth of the harmonica through mentorship and harmonica education. I love the harmonica. I have played the harmonica since I was 4 years old and joined SPAH when I was 12. That was nearly 43 years ago. I have personally experienced the positive impact that this harmonica community has on a person's life. I have built friendships that will last my lifetime. I have witnessed the family of SPAH embrace my daughter when she was 2 years old, running around this convention with a harmonica always in her mouth. You all have become more than friends. You have become grandpas and grandmas, uncles and aunts, and brothers and sisters to my little girl. And for that, I am eternally grateful for the lasting impact that you have made on her life. Because of the impact that SPAH has had on my life, I have chosen the path of higher education as I seek to advance the harmonica amongst school-age children. It is my goal and desire to see harmonicas taught in American public schools once again. studying for my Master of Arts degree in music education, harmonica performance. I researched the history of the harmonica in music education and wrote a thesis titled Harmonica Pedagogy for K-12 Music Education. Currently, through the study toward my Doctor of Music Education degree, with emphasis in harmonica pedagogy, I am composing another thesis, this time integrating my professional experience as a special education teacher into useful curriculum for music educators to provide appropriate harmonica instruction for all students. Thank you again for honoring me with the Stan Harper Award of Special Merit. As I continue to be an active participant in SPA, I pray that I am a catalyst for growth and awareness for the harmonica and this beloved organization. Thank you.
All right. Congratulations, George. Very well deserved, my friend.
Thank you very much, George. I'm back on now. Michael is too. And I'm going to have to hang up and call the second winner for the Stan Harper Award. Thanks again.
All right. So we're going to let Jerry go off camera. So congratulations, George. You can tell we've done this before, right? What a wonderful speech. George has invested his whole life in this instrument and in this organization. As you know, he plays with us, he sells products, he repairs products. His whole life is built around the harmonica and the instrument and the community. And so I can't think of a better recipient than George Miklas. And also, I've had the pleasure of working with Janlin, his daughter, over the last several years as a part of the youth committee. And Janlin has done some wonderful things to help us and was obviously herself a youth scholar earlier on in the Rosebush program. And so it's a great pleasure to have been able to present that award to George. And we will be sending him a physical copy of the award that you're more used to seeing here in the very near future. And that'll go in the mail to him. It would be so nice to be able to hand it to him at this point, but we're unable to do that. And so I think Jerry's ready with our second winner. Jerry, would you like to come back and join me?
You bet. Steve, you're on.
So the second award winner is Steve Watney. Please join me in congratulating Steve.
Okay, Steve, I don't know if you can hear Michael, but he just announced you as winner. And I'm going to put you on the speaker now.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Hi, Michael.
Hey.
I tell you, I'm really touched, and I tell you, I've been part of the SPA organization for close to 30 years, and you've all become very close friends of mine, and I'm really touched. Thank you very much for the award.
Is that right?
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay. Michael's going to say a little bit more, and we're going to move on. But I'm glad you won the award. It's very well deserved.
Congratulations, Steve.
Again, very much, everybody.
Well deserved. Also, anytime we have two wonderful nominees like that, it's hard for us to decide, and sometimes we decide to split, and create two awards. And so I'm very pleased that we did that this year. And I can't think of two people who are better deserving in George Miklas and Steve Watney. So hopefully you're all cheering right now and for those two guys. And so the next award is the Pete Pedersen Lifetime Achievement Award. And I am going to read the description. The candidates must have a record of achievement over a long period of time, have established themselves as outstanding harmonica players, They're active in promoting the preservation and advancement of the instrument and have meaningful interactions with players and devotees, are generous in sharing their talents and knowledge. They remain accessible to the harmonica community. So they're not just doing all the lifetime achievement, but they share that with us and with the community and that we serve here at SPAH and in general around the harmonica community. The nominees this year for the Pete Pedersen Award are Cajun harmonica player and teacher Jerry Davilia, player and teacher Jerry Fierro, player, custom harmonica builder, and teacher Joe Felisco, jazz virtuoso William Gallison, player, teacher, and author John Gindick, player, teacher, and author Adam Gussow, player, teacher, harmonica repair technician George Miklas, and longtime Willie Nelson accompanist Mickey Raphael. And if Jerry's ready to join us, let me be. I would like to announce the winner of the award. Are we ready, Jerry? There's Jerry once again on my left. And the winner is Jerry Davilia.
Jerry, you're on. Go ahead and say something.
Well, hello, Mr. Michael, and hello, Mr. Jerry, and hello, everybody at SPAH. I am absolutely thrilled to death and so surprised, and I just want to say how much I really enjoy going to the SPA and playing and teaching, and how much I've learned at the SPA. Because when I went to my first SPA, somebody approached me and said something about, did I do second position? And I thought it was. I said, well, maybe this person, I know what he's talking about. I'm standing behind somebody and I'd be number two player. That's I knew nothing about the harmonica. I knew nothing technical about it. And I've learned so much. And it's been a slippery slope. But SPAH has really, really changed my life. I can actually say that it's probably been my biggest life changer, because I don't get to play much here in Louisiana. Most people don't even know I play. And so I really want to thank everybody that voted for me, and thank the SPAH for giving me so much and learned so much and met so many nice people that it's I just can't tell you how grateful I am. So thank you, everybody, and thank you for allowing me to be here with you now and receiving this award, because it's probably the biggest thing that happened to me in my life.
Thank you very much, Jerry. It's well deserved, and I'm glad I could get you on the phone for this. We'll be sending you the award in the mail, and it was good talking to you, and I'll see you again later tonight, probably on Zoom.
Okay, sure will, Jerry. Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I am so pleased that Jerry has been awarded this award this year. He's done so many wonderful things for the instrument, for fiddle and Cajun music on the harmonica, and certainly if there was ever an achievement of a lifetime, Jerry Davilia would fit that description to a T. And so now we're going to switch things around a little bit, and I'm going to go get somebody on the phone while Jerry talks and reads something about Harmonica Player of the Year Award. So Jerry, take it away.
All right. Thank you, Michael. It's really been great so far. So this is the Bernie Bray Harmonica Player of the Year Award. The candidates must show proficiency and excellence in playing the harmonica and distinction in demonstrating or attained recently, preferably during the last year or 12 months, this expertise and proficiency. The nominees for the 2020 Bernie Bray Award are jazz virtuoso William Gallison, blues harmonica soloist Steve Geiger, who we saw last night, harmonica player and worldwide video artist Aki Kumar, who we also saw last night, jazz virtuoso Henrik Merkens, versatile chromatic virtuoso and bandleader Antonio Serrano, and last but not least, my friend and player and teacher, Ronnie Schellest. These guys are all deserving, and let me tell you, it was hard to make a decision out of these 25 candidates for all these three awards. One reason we ended up with two for the Stan Harper. And I think at this point, we have the winner on the phone. And that winner, and well-deservedly so, is Antonio Serrano. Michael?
And with a bit of luck, I have Antonio Serrano on the telephone from... Antonio, can you please... you may have something running on your side.
Hello?
Can you hear me? Okay.
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, good. Well, Antonio, you are the Harmonica Player of the Year Award for SPAH this year, and the Bernie Bray Harmonica Player of the Year Award. I'm sorry, I had you on mute. My apologies. And Antonio, you are the...
Yes, I can hear you now.
Yeah, okay, I'm sorry. I had you muted. We have your picture on the screen, and you are the Bernie Bray Harmonica Player of the Year this year. And I want to congratulate you. I have a microphone right next to my cell phone here, and Jerry Deal and I are, and the rest of the SPAH community would love to hear a few words from you, if you'd like to talk to us.
Well, thank you very much. I mean, I'm really surprised and honored to be the winner, you know, of this amazing prize. You know, I mean, especially because it's an award given by harmonica players, harmonica professionals, and it always touches you especially, you know, you get a prize from people of the profession. And well, the only thing I can say is that I've devoted all my life to this instrument. I really love it, and I think it's still an instrument to be discovered. I think it still doesn't have enough projection in the musical world, and it's probably one of the most soulful instruments in the world. So, I mean, the fact that you are doing this, you're giving this prize and you're organizing these events, I think it's a great thing for the instrument, and I'm really, really happy and honored to be chosen for this prize. I mean, it's something I'll remember the rest of my life. I've had a few prizes given to me in the past, but I think this is the first one coming from professional harmonica players and real good aficionados. So, I mean, thank you very much. It makes me really, really happy and makes me feel that it's been worth it, all the work I've done in my life and all the energy and good vibes that I've put on the instrument. Thank you very much, really.
Congratulations, Antonio, and thank you once again for the fine masterclass you did this afternoon. I know it's about 2 in the morning at your time, and we're going to be going to our break here very soon and then looking forward to listening to your performance that you recorded for us a few weeks ago, probably only a few days ago in Spain. And you're on the East Coast, I believe, of Spain these days, right?
Yes, I'm in the East Coast. Spending some time with my family, and well, I hope I can go back to Madrid soon. But right now, everything is very uncertain here in Spain and many parts of the world. So I don't know really what I'm going to do. But right now, I'm having nice time here, nice weather, a little bit too warm. But I'm okay. I mean, I'll join you during the concert and. I'll be there just in case there are some comments that we might talk about. So, I mean, it's pretty late here, but I'm so excited that I'm fine. I mean, I'm not tired at all. I'm fine.
Excellent, Antonio. Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate it. Thanks for sticking with us. And we will look forward to your performance very shortly. I'll say goodbye for now and see you on the chat.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Be safe. Thank Bye-bye. You. Okay. That was an experience, Jerry. What do you think, my friend?
Pulled it off, I think. I don't know, but that was a definitely an experiment. I think it worked out. We went through a couple of different ideas on how to do this. Some of them with technical difficulties, but this is as smooth as I think we could have made it.
Yes, it was an experiment, I have to say. It's the first time we've done a picture-in-picture. It's the first time we've had award winners join us. Not the first time by phone. I actually did it with Madcat several years ago on stage. It was a little simpler standing there in the room. It's been a little more complicated to do this with cell phones and cameras and computer screens. So, Jerry, thank you very much for your help in presenting these awards. I'm going to give you the rest of the evening to not quite off, because if my computer breaks, you'll be back. But I'm going to let you enjoy the rest of the show. And thank you very much, my friend. We're going to run a video, and it's Cham-Ber Huang. And I believe this is from 1995, a SPA 1995. So please enjoy that, and then we'll come back to the next performance, and I'll introduce that. Thank you. great. Cham-Ber Huang, what a wonderful performance. I am really pleased that we've had all this wonderful chromatic music over the course of the last 4 days. I think we've really added a tremendous amount to what we've been able to do here with all the chromatic instruments, and certainly this evening is no exception to that. In fact, I have mine sitting right here because I was trying to play along with Antonio earlier during the class. I hope many of you had the opportunity to sit through that class. One of the things I wanted to do, because I realize that not everybody here may be a member of SPAH, or if you are, you might be a new member. One of the things that you get, this is the commercial, is this incredible magazine. We still print a real magazine. It's called Harmonica Happenings. And this year, it's full of all the photographs and bios of our performers and presenters, as well as the schedule, and a great interview with Jerry Portnoy that is not to be missed. And that is something that you get 4 times a year, whether you're living in Austin, Texas, or whether you're living in Paris, France. We will get it to you, and it's of tremendous value, and it's shipped in a bag that decomposes more quickly. It's shipped in a plastic bag, but it's one that decomposes, so we're careful about the environment. And I certainly enjoy reading it every time, and writing a little introductory letter when I do that. So that brings us to our first performer this evening. And I'm pleased to say, of course, that it is Antonio Serrano. And I know Antonio is in the Zoom chat room at 2 a.m. I think he's pretty hyped up and happy. And congratulations once again, Antonio, for being Harmonica Player of the Year at SPAH. I'm so glad that we were able to have you with us both doing the masterclass and then doing the performance here this evening. I met Antonio 3 years ago when I arrived. Brenda, my wife, and I had arrived at Stuttgart Airport, and I'd been asked by Hohner to pick up a couple of people. One of them was from Hohner, and the other one was Antonio. And so we met in the Stuttgart Airport, and we drove with suitcases on our knees, although I was the driver, so everybody else had a suitcase on their knees because we had a lot of people in there. Maybe there were four, no, because it was Brenda and I had 2 others, that's right. It was a lot of people. We had a decent sized vehicle, and we spent, you know, an hour and a half driving at some, German speed, about an hour and a half down to this lovely village of Trossingen in the Black Forest in southern Germany to join the World Harmonica Forum. And Antonio was performing there. He was also a judge, and I'd been invited to be a judge in one of the diatonic competitions. And so we got to know each other on that trip, and ever since then, and obviously we got to see him perform in this beautiful Lutheran church in Trossingen. And also I sat in on one of his classes. And so ever since then, I've really wanted to try and find a way to get him to come to SPAH. And this year he was going to come. Unfortunately, obviously, we haven't been able to do that this year. And so he is now living in the east coast of Spain with the hopes of going back to his home in Madrid before too long. As you know, Spain has had a particularly difficult time, much like the U.S. has had this year. We're hopeful that he will be able to join us again next year. He does tour the United States frequently. He is an incredible harmonica player. Those of you who sat through his masterclass will know that he likes to play a 12-hole 270. That's what he learned to play on. He was showing some of his virtuosity in that setting, talking about embouchure, talking about the flamenco and some of the things he does with flamenco music, as well as with classical and with jazz. The performance you're going to see this evening is Antonio playing the piano, which he also does masterfully, and accompanying himself playing the chromatic harmonica. And I think you will really enjoy this performance he did specially for us. And so without further ado, please welcome our 2020 Harmonica Player of the Year award winner, Antonio Serrano. Thank you.
Hello, harmonica friends. My name is Antonio Serrano. I play the chromatic harmonica, and I was invited this year to the SPAH convention, but due to the COVID pandemic crisis that we had all around the world, it couldn't take place. So we are recording our concerts so that all of you harmonica lovers around the world, and especially those that intended to attend the SPAH convention this year, can enjoy the music and some nice harmonica playing from the players that were invited to this edition. So I just played a piece by Tárrega, a Spanish composer that he mainly wrote for classical guitar. And this piece is composed in a tremolo for the tremolo technique in the guitar, which is basically the tremolo effect playing the melody and some bass notes on the low register. And I've been using this tremolo effect on the harmonica for a while, which consists on moving the tongue very fast from one side to the other. And I like to use it in this piece. Sounds, well, you already heard it, but something like... And it really suits this piece because the piece is written for that technique. The next piece I would like to play is a set of etudes I wrote a few years ago for harmonica and some piano accompaniment too. These etudes, they are also based on some classical progressions. The first etude is based on the harmonic progression of Libertango, and I tried to write an etude in the style of Bach's partitas or preludes for solo instruments, and on the end there are some fast arpeggios that remind probably Paganini's caprichos. Well, I like all that music, and I tried to put it into these etudes. The second etude is based on the harmonic progression of an etude by Chopin. I think it's number 6. And the third is just a solo harmonica etude on that same progression. So I hope you enjoy it. Etudes number 1, 2, and 3. Thank you. Okay. For the next pieces, I want to bring on the stage a friend, a colleague, a great piano player. Her name is Connie Lechner. Please.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to play a piece written by Pablo Sarasate. This is a violin and piano piece called Zapateado, which is a very virtuoso and difficult piece for the violin. And it has plenty of arpeggios, scales, double stops. And it's written on the key of A. So when I was working on this piece, I tried to do something with it on the C harmonica, but eventually I thought it would sound better, and I could actually play some of the double stops if I used an A harmonica, and everything, even the register, kind of suited perfectly for an A chromatic harmonica. So this is our arrangement based on the original. Basically, there's not much difference. Any difference at all, actually. And this is Zapateado by Pablo Sarasate. Thank you. Okay. The next piece that we're gonna play was written by a Spanish composer also, Manuel de Falla, and it belongs to an opera. It's a dance that's played at the beginning of an act, and there is a version for violin and piano, and the arrangement that we've done for harmonica and piano is based both on that arrangement and also on the orchestral part which has a lot of music that's not in the piano arrangement. So we've worked both in both scores to do this arrangement for chromatic harmonica in C and in piano. La danza de la vida breve. Continue with two pieces by Astor Piazzolla, This was an Argentinian composer, as you all know. And he played the bandoneon, which is an instrument of the same family as the harmonica. So the harmonica suits very well this music. We're going to play Oblivion in the first place, which is a beautiful ballad. And then we will finish with Adios Nonino, which was written after Piazzolla's father's death. So it's a very emotional and inspired piece of music. I should say that most of the music that is written and the scores of Piazzolla's music is not accurately what he plays on his recordings, because he was an amazing improviser and performer, and also his most famous pieces he recorded many times in different arrangements. So the arrangements we have done have been elaborated by listening to all different live and studio versions of these pieces, and we've kind of chosen what we like more of each arrangement, and we've made a kind of a mix, but based not only on the scores, but especially on his live and studio performances. Thank you. Thank you very much. Constanza Legner, Connie Legner on the piano. My name is Antonio Serrano. I hope you enjoyed the concert, and we're all getting used to this new way of life. And this is probably our first concert like this, in the house, recording and that. But well, we hope you enjoyed it, and I hope next year or soon we can be there with you and attend the SPAH convention. Thank you very much, and see you soon.
Mm-hmm. And what a wonderful performance that was by Antonio Serrano. I was looking at the comments on YouTube and listening to a report of some of the comments from you on Zoom, and it sounds like everybody had a really good time. And I know that Antonio stayed up to enjoy and chatter with you guys while we were listening to it. So that was a wonderful performance. And Antonio, once again, thank you very much. We hope to see you in person next year. We hope we can make that happen on every level possible, because it'll mean, if nothing else, that we have a live convention next year. As we were unable to do so a little earlier, I'd like to invite past president and awards committee chair Winslow Yerxa up to join me, I think, on my left. There he is. And I wanted Winslow to say a few words about the awards and some of our winners this evening before we go to the break.
Yeah, gosh. One of the things that I really wanted to emphasize is that if you're a SPA member, you have the power to make nominations. You know, that's how we get nominations. And I mean, we had a wonderful, strong field of candidates this year. But I just want to emphasize that this is a level process in terms of actually finding people to nominate. Another thing that occurred to me while Antonio was playing, and what a wonderful performance, is that this is a living tradition. You know, we've got people alive who are wonderful. We have awards named for people, for those of us who remember them, also know were wonderful. And it's really great to see people like George Miklas and Steve Watney and Jerry DeVilliers, and all of whom I count as friends, and Antonio, who is so wonderful, and I certainly hope to get to meet him again in person. I've seen him perform live. Anyway, it's just wonderful that all of this is going on. And despite everything that we're facing and the little glitches that didn't allow me to speak earlier, I was going to read the nominees. That's how that was supposed to work. Anyway, happy we're all here together by whatever means. And, we will, I understand, actually be hearing from one of the people for whom one of our awards is named. And I think you will appreciate, at least from a performance perspective, why we want to honor Pete Pedersen. I mean, he was a wonderful performer, but he was also a generous, giving musician to other harmonica players and a consummate professional. We had a SPA one year, gosh, 1994, I believe it was, in Memphis, which was Pete's town. And we saw the respect and the love that the entire musical community, I've got a lot of echoes, so it sounds a little weird to hear myself on slight delay. But to see the respect that he commanded in the wider musical community, along with the entire harmonica community, was really great to see. So, gosh, that's about all I've got to say right now. Sorry. Let's enjoy the rest of the evening, Michael.
Winslow, thank you. I'm so glad we were able to make this work and that you were able to join us this evening. It's your fine work and support that allows us to go through that process and the encouragement. So I really appreciate everything you do for SPA, and I know everybody who's listening does too. As Winslow said, we have another wonderful video to take us through the break, so you guys can go get a beverage or visit the little room down the hall. I may do that myself. It is from SPA 1997, August 23rd, and this is the Pete Pedersen and his band. And I hope you enjoy this, and I'll see you in a few minutes. Like this. What a wonderful performance by one of our early SPA members, and after whom one of our awards is named, Pete Pedersen. That was a really fabulous piece of history from the archives that Jerry Deal has put together for us. All of that is posted on the archive, and we encourage you to go have a listen, take a look. There's all kinds of, pretty much everything you've seen here is there. Over the course of the last 4 days. Okay, so I would like to introduce our next act. You've seen the Tom Stryker Big Band group at SPA for the last several years, and we've had the opportunity to watch a group of virtuosos, including Wenzel Yerkeser, who was just up here with me, as well as many others, playing some of the jazz standards from the American Songbook. And we went to Tom this year and said, what can you do during the days of COVID to give us that sort of experience? And I think you will see when we run the tape how amazingly well he did this. The Message is a Reno-based group. It is a six-piece band formed by group leader Mick Valentino. Features Craig Fletcher, Tom Stryker, Tony Savage, Joe McKenna, Terry Campillo, and our own Carolyn Dolan as a special guest. They all live in and around the Lake Tahoe area, in and around Reno, Nevada, which is an area I love. I spent a year and a half working for a software company in that area. It's a beautiful part of the world. It's really hot at this time of year. So hot the airplanes can't take off with a full load. Not that that's a problem this year. And we went to Tom and said, how can you do this? And they put their heads together and came back and said, we can pull this off. We have a club that will allow us to come out there and put on a performance. And so that's what you're about to see, is a performance socially distanced. Of the sort of music that we've come to love from Tom Stryker and his colleagues. A little backstory here. You'll see a wonderful automobile arrive in the front of the show. And my understanding is that there was actually a fire burning near Tom's house. And he drove that car to the gig to get it out of the garage. But it made such a beautiful prop for the performance. I think you will really enjoy how it starts. And so without further ado, please let me introduce The Message.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Living the Good Life. This is The Message for you. Thank you. Sir Tony is going to kick this one off for you. Dig it! You know, in these uncertain times, we need all the help we can get. And in these unprecedented times, we need to look to the help. Where is the help? A mechanic! Thank you. And in this global crisis, we need a
master mechanic.
You're the man right there.
There you go.
That's Tom Stryker. He's got a fender. He had an auto body shop. 18 years, this guy ran his own shop. I'm gonna tell a little story about that. Goes like this.
He's my body and fender man. He gonna fix my car. Brand new, or it has been worked around. The swell are all the same. He'll make them sweet and sound. Keep my body in the fender man. He can fix my car. Oh, yes he can. Well, when it comes to body and fender, hey, some kind of superstar. Come on, Craig, give it to me one time. US models, a foreign car or two. He's a master mechanic, and he knows just what to do. He's my body and fender man. He can fix my car. Oh, yes he can. Well, when it comes to body and fender, well, he's some kind of superstar. Thank you. your body. Shape your finger out and in. If you don't get it right the first time, you'll do it all over again. If a body is check this out. This is a diatonic harmonica, and it has a few notes on it.
Now, blues, baby.
That's right. Yeah, a lot of blues is played on that too, but you know, I like a little jazz too. So, now, the master mechanic, please, on the chromatic, show him how many notes you got, Tom. What do you think?
So that's a man's harmonica.
And you know what, Carolyn? I have a button on mine.
Oh, my God. That's getting personal.
I got a front and back on mine.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you all for being here. This was a taping session for SPA, the Society for the Preservation and Advancement of the Harmonica. And thanks to Gina for allowing us to use Living the Good Life. And of course, the members of the band. On the drums, Tony Savage. Thank you. On the bass, Joe McKenna. Vocals and guitar, Craig Fletcher. Our leader of the group, Mick Valentino. And my name is Tom Stryker. Thank you for being here, and here's Carolyn Dolan. Thank you.
What a fabulous performance by The Message. Well done to Tom and Carolyn and the rest of that band in Carson City, Nevada, playing to a real audience. I'm impressed. And I'm even more impressed by the fact that Tom seems to be able to instruct the sun to move backwards. I guess it's the earth that's moving backwards, not the sun, when I come to think about it. But it seemed to get lighter during the afternoon there. But anyhow, what a wonderful performance. Really enjoyable. A bunch of fabulous musicians and a fine performance by all concerned. And a good way to see what a chromatic and a diatonic can do when paired with horns and a wonderful jazz section. So congratulations, guys. Great. We're going to take a break here for a little while and listen to another set with Pete Pedersen. This is from 1994, August 24th, and this features a whole cast of names that I know from the past, a few of which I've met. Pete Pedersen, Stan Harper, Ray Tankersley, Jerry Murad, Tom Stryker, Mo Vint, Alan Pogson, and Al and Judy Smith. Please welcome Pete Pedersen and his band.
One, two, three. Yeah.
here's a little one, an old tune called Rain. And I have to have an old harmonica here called 64.
That's how many times it rained this week.
Very apropos. One, two, three, four.
What a fabulous performance. Oh, that was a really good, wonderful jazz combo there with lots of stuff going on and 26 years ago. Great recording too, fabulous. Thank you again, Jerry, for pulling that one out of the hat. This brings us to our last performer of SPAH Week 2020. And I have to say, on a personal note, it's been a wonderful experience to pull this off. I'm going to breathe a little bit and go get some fresh air after we're done this evening. But boy, what a fine week of instruction, companionship, and music we've had. And no better way to top it off than with our 2008 Harmonica Player of the Year, Hermine 2018, I should say. And I lost 10 years there somehow. Hermine is from Amsterdam. I'll let you read her bio. It's available to you there. She won the award 2 years ago. She's not particularly well known in the United States, but very well known in Europe, and both a wonderful saxophonist as well as harmonica player, and has brought us a really fabulous recording and a really fine way to wrap up our Saturday evening banquet. I hope the tuxedos are all feeling a little tighter after a wonderful banquet meal together. And let's all raise our glasses to 2021 and wish everybody well. We'll see you after the show and say goodnight. But without further ado, please welcome Hermine Deurloo. Thank you.
Sunday afternoon. I got nothing to do. Won't you let me sit here, my friend? I'll share some words with you. My feet are on the ground, my head is in the clouds, and you got me wondering what it is you're thinking about. So can we have a conversation? Can we have a heart-to-heart? Old school communication, less than 2 feet apart. And can we have a real connection? Look each other in the eye. It's so nice to meet you. Hello, how are you? Goodbye. Goodbye. Sunday afternoon, I got nowhere to be. Won't you come and sit here, my friend? Share your thoughts with me. My back is feeling easy. Thoughts are calm and clear. If there's something on your mind, well, I'm all ears. So, can we have a conversation? Can we have a heart to heart? Old school communication, less than 2 feet apart. Can we have a real connection? Look each other in the eye. It's so nice to meet you. Hello, how are you? Goodbye. Goodbye. For me, our future's written down. Oh, have open arms to strangers and whatever comes around. My love is on the road, my head is in her heart.
Hermine Deurloo, y'all.
If we trust each other. We don't need one another. I said we can trust each other. We don't need one another. If I can't leave home without you thinking I'm doing wrong. If you can't go out on the town without me thinking you're messing around. If we can't trust each other ever, well, what's the use of us being together? If we can't trust each other, we don't need one another. I said if we can't trust each other, we don't. Get all uptight every time you're out of my sight. And if you can't go out on a town, so scared play around when you leave. Said if we can't trust each other ever, well, what's the use of us being together?
you walk with me down through the pines and stay with me until the end of time? You know the earth stands still when I hold you, and when you're not around, I nearly lose my mind. And it's oh so fine to know your mind. Thank you.
Mr. Steve Guts. Tony Scherer. Luca Benedetti. John Cowards.
What a wonderful performance by Hermine Deurloo. That was fabulous. Great camera work, great playing by everybody concerned. What a fabulous way to end the evening. Well, we've come to the end of SPAH 2020, and this is the point where we would all get in the hallways with our favorite beverage and play the night away, while some of us are taking down signs and putting things in boxes and thinking about the trip home the next day. But I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I have. It's been a fabulous time. And I would like to invite three of my colleagues up here to join me in saying goodnight. Come on up, guys. There they are. And these folks, as well as, what happened to Paul? Where'd he go?
He couldn't find his pants.
He's not down there. Paul, you missed it, man. We've had a fabulous time, and we hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. I know that we're going to keep the chat room open on Zoom so that everybody can say goodnight. Last night it went till 3 in the morning, and who knows, maybe it'll do that here, and you guys can have plenty of fun over there. So it's goodnight from me.
Good night, everybody. This has been a fantastic week. I'm exhausted. Not as bad as I would be running around the hotel, as Michael said earlier, but this has really been fun. It's great to see, as I call them, my annual friends, especially these three guys up here. I love seeing you guys. I love talking to you. I love seeing the people on Zoom. Some great seminars, some great performances. And it has really been fun. And with that, I'm going to say goodnight and pass it on to Winslow.
This has been such a rich week in such profusion of content. And it's been really wonderfully presented. I mean, this is the first time we've tried to do this. And I've been hearing how much goes on behind the scenes to really make this happen. And I've got to say, everyone has knocked out of the park. So, good night from me. Good for night from
one of the. Thanks, Winslow. This has been a week of great medicine for me. I've needed this medicine, and I got my SPAH harmonica medicine. Thank you, everyone. Thank everyone who's participated, from the performers to all of us that interacted with each other during these past 4 days. It's great medicine. And I'm going to see all of you in Charlotte in 2021.
Yeah, thank you, everybody. Good night, everybody. It's been a fabulous doing it with you. And thank you, Chris, in my headphones. You've done a fabulous job. Good night, everybody.
Chat room stays open.
Whispers through the cedars of a place where the water